Hey everyone, my name is Tyler Oakley.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Today, we're going to be talking about how and why Tyler Oakley's channel and career died. But before we get into the video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you're new and hit the bell notification so that you're notified whenever I post. Also, don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoy the video at the end. And don't forget to leave your comments down below letting me know what you guys think of the whole situation. I want to know what you guys have to say. Also, shameless self-promo, don't forget to check out my Instagram. I think I have a pretty nice Instagram feed. I don't know. No, in all seriousness, if you like photography or anything of that sort, then definitely check it out. Okay, long-ass intro is definitely over. Without further ado, let's get into the video. So let's start off with a basic introduction of who Tyler Oakley is and how he started his whole career slash channel. So Tyler Oakley uploaded his first video in 2007. And from there, his channel pretty much skyrocketed. He was pretty popular back in the day, probably during the same time that Zoella had her fame. I would say around 2013, 14, 15, maybe at the latest. But ever since then, no one has really been talking about him, and no one has really been watching him. Not only this, but he's been losing subscribers and losing views. He doesn't get as many views as he used to, and considering he has 7 million subscribers on his channel to date, that is not a good sign. And today, we're going to be talking about what happened and why. So, as I just mentioned, Tyler has 7.7 million subscribers on YouTube, and that's a lot. And I would say the average amount of views he gets for a video is maybe what, 100k? Some of his videos are as low as 55,000 views, and this guy has 7 million subscribers. That is not a good sign. This guy used to get millions and millions of views. Now, I actually loved Tyler Oakley back in the day, once upon a time. I thought he seemed really sweet, really genuine. I liked his content. But then I stopped watching him, and then I actually remember a while ago, I was like, whatever happened to the guy, you know? Like, what happened to his channel? No one really talks about him anymore. And after watching iNabber's video about the topic, reading some of the comments, and reading other stuff about him on the internet, I have come to the conclusion that his downfall was the same reason that Zoella's channel and career died. So many people said that he never changed up his content, it got boring and repetitive, and a lot of people said that he never evolved with his audience, which is basically what people are saying and observing for Zoella, and I've mentioned it in my Zoella video. When Tyler Oakley was at his peak time on YouTube, I'd say most of his fans and subscribers were quite young, maybe in the teens to preteen age. And it's been a few years now, and most of them have grown up. And I think that he probably thinks that since his content got so many views back then, he probably never really changed it up because he thought that that's what's going to keep him successful, and that's what's going to keep the views pouring in and the money pouring in. But realistically, his fans and his fan base grew up, and they got tired of seeing 2014 content. Now, some people say he's hated because of a couple tweets he's made in the past regarding personal preference in terms of who you're attracted to. He said that if you're not attracted to a certain race, it's just plain racism. And that's a whole nother topic, but a lot of people say that some of the things he's tweeted politically has led to people hating him and has led to his downfall, which I actually disagree with. I don't think people are unsubscribing because they hate him or they disagree with his politics or whatnot. I mean, it's definitely possible there are probably some people who disagree with his politics and therefore unsubscribe to him. But I think the main reason that he's losing subscribers isn't because of his politics and isn't because of the tweets he made in the past, because his tweets he made in the past were a bit controversial. But it's not like he was tweeting blatant racist things like Laura Lee. Trends come and go, and he kind of stuck on the 2014 trend, and I think a lot of his subscribers and fanbase grew and they changed interest as well. And they started watching the YouTubers that could cater to the content that they want to see. Now, I wanted to kind of get to the core of this, and I know that I used to watch Tyler Oakley. I actually really enjoyed his content back in the day. And I really thought to myself, what changed? Why did I stop watching him? And how did I even forget that this guy existed? I honestly don't remember the point at which I stopped watching Tyler Oakley, but I decided to go to his channel and actually look at the types of videos he's making. Not just the views, but the actual content itself. Now, one person said that he tends to make a lot of Q&As, which goes for lazy content. And I don't think a lot of people like Q&As. I've known and I've heard that Q&As don't get as many views as regular videos. I definitely think it's okay to do a Q&A here and there. People have definitely asked the YouTubers that they love for Q&As because they want to get to know them more than just their content. They want to get to know them as a person. But to do them extremely frequently isn't okay, in my opinion. I think that does go to show that you are lazy. If you can sit down and actually come up with a creative idea that's new, that's popular, that's unique, and actually put effort into it and show that you're putting effort into it and show that you care about YouTube and your subscribers, then I definitely think that he would get a ton of more views. And I personally think the reason that I stopped watching his videos is because I just got bored of him and his content. He really needs to amp things up if he wants to get the attention of new viewers. Because I still think it's possible, I still think there is time for redemption, but he just needs to get on that right now and really figure things out for his channel, see what his subscribers want, talk to them, ask them, and really step up his game. That was it for today's video. Let me know what you thought of it in the comments down below. Let me know your opinions in general on the subject. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe and hit the bell notification so you're notified whenever I post. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!